Sorry, I am Dr. Safi from 19 North Terrace. That is the area directly affected by Area D, southern boundary. I would like to briefly talk about two areas, main areas, one in general. I was talking to a prominent psychologist in criminal behavior last week, and he was looking at the council proposed quarantine, and his professional opinion, it will increase the anti-social behavior to range of criminal activity, that is drugs, rapes, etc. If this is not looked into very carefully. I can say from our humble private observations, because there is a tree next to us, definitely it invites, and we can say funny stories and, about antisocial behavior for that tree, and maybe others can comment about it. The second general point, I understand from the tree experts, and when I met your tree expert, the council tree expert, confirmed that too, that some of the trees proposed need 2,000 liters of water per tree per day. And I will leave it to your imagination to the effect it will have. Now, if I may move into specifics. We delivered our objections, we, that is, regarding Plan D, the residents, all residents signed a petition against the Plan D from number 8 to number 19, North Terrace. And you received it on the 8th of 9. Here it is. In the questionnaire, there were only two alternatives, nothing else. Either infill trees to be regularly spaced parallel to the boundary, or infill trees to be informal clusters of trees following the slope. No others. The questionnaire is clearly, in its whole, it seems, slanted to what the council legally wishes and is not a fair one. I'm talking about the design of the questionnaires. In your paper, you state, in your handout, for the scheme, you state that the council has met and taken advice and guidance from local residents. And all from number 8 to number 16 at North Terrace confirmed, and you will see it also in your papers, and they are not conscious of the fact that you haven't, we have been consulted. Most of us have lived at North Terrace 20 to 40 years because of the long views over the common and the river camp. It's difficult to get an open space in the city center unless you are a professor who's living in a college. We have about 200 degrees Vestas with its special light. Even some of us have altered their houses to take views of the common, which is unparalleled. residents from 8 to 16 would feel badly served by the council if we were to implement Plan D and be clearly responsible for loss of amenity. Any damage, including all liabilities, were properties to suffer subsidence now or later in the future as a result of planting proposed. There are also other issues of insurance problems and getting a cover, and this is well documented. I would like to draw particular point about the English documentary about the disastrous effects because of trees were away 30 to 35 meters away from houses and how the houses suffered and the huge cost that incurred as a result of the trees. And obviously, in the end of the day, after the 6 months grace for the council to reply, in the end of the day, they had to pay a lot of compensation to put everything right.
I think we certainly got the gist of where you're going with this one. And
would you mind another 2 points?
But the point is, this area of planting is to go for further consultation. That point was made at the beginning of the meeting. And I hate to cut you off, but you're going to have your chance, that your group of residents are going to have a further chance. So I would really like to go on and give someone else a chance.
Councillors, if you allow me, just, we believe our concerns as at North Terrace, building at North Terrace, should have and carry a greater weight than the opinions of those influenced by mainly aesthetics planting. And it's very clear we object to planting Plan D at North Terrace.
Right. Thank you. Thank you. Your points are very clear. I saw two hands fly up.